Then the fourth question. The question is, ما قولكم في مسألة علو الله على الخلق واستوائه على العرش? What is the statement about the مسألة of the that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is above his creation and he is over his throne subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is where the people of Ahl Sunnah and Jama'ah there upon with regards to the names and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which we know, alhamdulillah, and we need to be upon this and to be firm upon it, that anything that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran or in the Sunnah of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam of his names and attributes, we believe in them and we know the meaning of it, but without any resemblance or similarities to the attributes of the human beings. And the how of it, we do not know. Allah knows best, because there's no how is being explained. And we say, لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِي شَيْءٍ وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْبَصِيرُ. Nothing is the like of Allah, and He's the all-hearer, the all-seer. So the belief in the علو of Allah is that we know and we believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is علي, and He is the most high subhanahu wa ta'ala, with every meaning to it. That's why there's three things with the ulama they mention when it comes to the ulu of Allah. Ulu with that, we need to remember these points. Ulu with that, which is he's the most exalted in essence, in being, above his creation, above his throne, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ar-Rahmanu ala arshi istawa. Ulu with that. And ulu al-qadr, that he's the most exalted in status, in being, that no one can defeat Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is the most powerful, he's the most high. So علو القدر والصفات, that his attributes are the most perfect attributes. No one, nothing is the like of Allah. So he's the most exalted subhanahu wa ta'ala when it comes to his attributes. And this is the second one. And علو القهر. علو القهر is that he's the most exalted, the most high in prevailing over his creation. That everybody is under the power of Allah. وَهُوَ الْقَاهِرُ فَوْقَ عِبَادِ. Al-Qahr is when a human being to a human being is not a good thing. When someone make qahr on someone, that's a bad thing. Someone oppresses someone. Someone becomes under the control of someone else. But it's from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to his creation. This is a beautiful thing, because he's the creator of all things. So the ulu of Allah, that he's the most exalted, the most high, when it comes to al-qahr, that means he's prevailing over his creation. So these are the three types of ulu. Ulu with that, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most high in essence, in his being subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the most high in his perfect attributes subhanahu wa ta'ala, and ulu al-qahr, which is the ulu of prevailing over his creation. So these are the three things, or the three meanings of the ulu of Allah. And that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ba'inu min khalqihi mustawin ala arshi, is above his creation, and he is rose over his throne subhanahu wa ta'ala, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described himself. So as Imam Malik rahimahullah, that he mentioned his statement here without quoting Imam Malik rahimahullah in it, al-istiwa'u ma'lum. Al-istiwa', which is the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is over his throne, is known. Wal-kayfu majhul. And how, al-kayf, is the how of it, is majhul, we do not know, because we've not been informed of the kayf. فَقَدْ أَخْبَرَنَا أَنَّهُ اسْتَوَى وَلَمْ يُخْبِرْنَا عَنْ كَيْفِيَّةٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala informed us that he is استوى على العرش, but he did not inform us of how. وَكَذَلِكَ نَقُولَ. And the same thing we say with all of the attributes of Allah, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala informed us about it, and he did not inform us of how these attributes are. So we have to believe in everything that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala informed us in the Quran and in the Sunnah of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. We don't do more or less. This is the proper belief in the names and attributes of Allah, without differentiating between one or the other, like those who indulged in philosophy and things that is of no benefit whatsoever, thinking that they're exalting Allah or something else. So, but again, this is the belief. So the mas'ala of ulu of Allah, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most high, the most exalted subhanahu wa ta'ala, in these three meanings, in the essence, in the perfect attributes, in the prevailing over his creation, that he's over his creation and he's over his throne subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-istiwa'u ma'lum, wal-kayfu majhul. The how is unknown, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not inform us of the how. And where do we get informed about these types of things? Is in the Quran and in the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ. We don't add anything and we don't take away anything. And we don't go by sins, therefore, when it comes to the attributes of Allah. This is for the human beings. A human being has something, therefore something else. But when it comes to the names and attributes of Allah, we just take it the way it is. So this is one question.